I've mentioned about the Illuminati, I've mentioned about the reptilians, I've mentioned about Montauk Point, but I need to give you the history of the backup of all of this. And I need to explain to you also about the history of this galaxy, and particularly the solar system, because it's pertinent to what's going on now and will give you an understanding of why the reptilians have the mindset that they do. Now, the reptilians have a mindset that's very different than what humanity has. Reptilians believe that they are superior to all others. And as I mentioned at the bookstore last night, one of the reasons is they are androgynous. They have male and female in the same body. And since this is representative of what exists outside of physical reality, where there is no male or female gender, it's just energy, they consider themselves superior for bringing that type of information to physical reality. You'll also note, based on observing creatures on the Earth right now, that reptilian forms do not evolve or adapt over eons or millions of years. They basically stay the same. And if there's a change, they just die out. Whereas mammalian forms need to adapt and evolve as there are changes occurring in their environment. So to the reptilian mind pattern, they're superior because they don't need to change or adapt. Therefore, they're completely perfect as they are. That's the mindset. It's not right. It's not wrong. It's just the way they think. And so they go after the Aryan types, or the blonde hair, red hair, blue eyes, green eyes, because the genetics of those people are easily controlled. The mind control over that genetic is very, very easy as compared to other races. This is why in history, those who saw globalization or control of this planet wanted to promote the Aryan race as the natural form, because those who did this were being controlled by the reptilians. And they found up every reason they could think of to make other civilizations or races look inferior. They manufactured that. The reptilians drove another object into the solar system to colonize the Earth. We now call that object the moon. The moon is the only known object in space that's supposed to be natural, that doesn't spin. It faces in one direction all the time, like a ship in orbit, and that's exactly what it is. If you send a sonic resonance off of the moon, it pings like a glass, hollow glass. It's not solid. If it were solid, the sonic resonance would make a thump or a bang sound. It doesn't. And in fact, to this very day, if you have a telescope, especially on a full moon, and you train your telescope at any crater in the moon, you will see activity there. You will see lights moving, you will see vehicles moving, you will see buildings. You can do this if you have a telescope, and it doesn't have to be an expensive telescope either. And they colonized a continent, and there were two main continents at the time. A continent that is known as, or was known as, Lemuria, or in some civilizations they called it Mu. These were reptilian beings. This continent extended over the Pacific basin. The remnants of it now are Australia and New Zealand, the South Pacific Islands, the Philippines, Japan, and Hawaiian Islands, as well as the coast of California west of the San Andreas Fault Line. That was Lemuria. And one of the plant life that still exists on this planet from Lemuria are the redwood trees. That is what was covering Lemuria. Have any of you ever walked through the redwood forest? It's a very strange sensation, very heavy feeling, but there's kind of an ancientness to it. And it only exists in that one little area by the coastline. Now, they existed on this continent, this vast continent, for many thousands of years. And they colonized an area that we knew as Sumer. Now, what do you think happened to the remnants of the reptilians after Lemuria sank? Anybody? Many of them, if not all that were left, went underground. They went inside the earth. And so, I have another flowchart to give you, which will show you what the reptilians did, because they don't give up, ever. They are insidious in what they do. They decided, now that they were inside the earth, they were not on the moon anymore, they were cut off, basically, from the Draco star system, what are they going to do? They wanted to recapture the earth in the best way possible, and the best way would be by genetic breeding, hybridization with the human beings on the planet. Now, as far as the reptilians are concerned, once the Lemuria sank, they went underground, and I told you about the hybridization program. That began in Sumer. That was one of the first places that the human reptilian DNA mix for the shape-shifting reptilians began. There are statues in Sumer showing Semiramis with a human form, a reptilian face, reptilian claws and feet, holding a hybrid baby. That's what they worshipped in Sumer. You can see the picture in any magazine or book related to Sumerian civilization.